I think I caught up with everything. I don't know. It's been such a roller coaster. So he banned the jet tracking Twitter account and then like made this statement about doxing being bad and everyone will be banned for doxing. And then like 2 hours later, he doxed a guy in a car in a mask. He's like, "Does anyone recognize this license plate and this guy?" Like literally 2 hours later, he just posted a video of it. And then after being called out for banning a bunch of journalists that were talking about it, he entered a call with the journalists and they just directly confronted him like, "You realize what you've done is the same thing you criticized Twitter for when they like restricted access to Hunter Biden's files, right?" And then he's just like, "Doxing is bannable, ban evasion is bannable," and then left and then shut down all of Twitter Spaces. It was a rough voice call. Oh, god damn. Thank you for the 21 gift subs, Zengerda. Jesus Christ, man. Thank you for the generosity this morning. Thanks for the gift sub elixir. Wasn't the guy in the car stalking his kid? So that was the story. And then I read, and this, I guess, could be an unconfirmed report. But then I read that that situation never even got a, like a police report filed or anything. And authorities were made aware of it, but had no actual police report on it. Which is like a contradiction to the claim. Thanks, Erisim Fields. But regardless, he looked real weak in that Twitter Spaces call. I don't know why he bothered going in there when he was going to be that sensitive and on edge. That was a terrible look. Even if you agreed with him banning people that were posting his real-time jet info, him going in that call was a net yuckiness. Yikes. But yeah, this has been a wild a wild morning catching up on all the Elon Musk shit. I already finished Choo Choo Charles. Is the Prime Bull. Hear about the aquarium collapse in Berlin? I didn't. Did you see the poll he posted on Twitter to see if he should unban the jet tracker? Didn't get the response he wanted and made an excuse to do another? Yeah. So he made a poll saying, "Should I unban the jet tracker now? Never? In 7 days? In 30 days?" So he gave like four options and now won 43%. And he's like, "I gave too many options. I'm gonna have to do this again with less options." It was so stupid. It was so fucking stupid. Why do you care about it? It's just entertaining, man. The guy whose like whole thing was about free speech, even making that tweet where like, "I care so much about free speech, I will never ban the Elon Musk jet tracker." And now not even a month later, he banned them and made this huge song and dance whining and crying all over Twitter, making polls to see if anyone agrees with him. Like, it's just entertaining. Going into Twitter spaces and making himself look like a goddamn fool. How can you not laugh about that? Oh, also in that call, there's one other thing that had me giggling really hard. It's very clear he's kind of new to the internet itself because he doesn't know what ban evasion means. So he kept equating ban evasion to posting links that linked to the Elon jet tracker and saying that that's ban evading. When ban evading is when you get banned and make like another account under different information in order to circumvent your ban. So he doesn't even really fucking get what these terms mean. It's so goofy. It's so silly. Thanks to Prime Bayonetta, Slimy, and the resub mate. He's terminally online and doesn't know what ban evasion is. No, because he locks himself in a fucking bubble. So he never actually learns any real information anymore. And then when he escapes that bubble for a brief second, like when he went to the Twitter spaces with the journalists, he gets fucking embarrassed. And then he just retreats back into his little hidey hole. His little echo chamber. Online echo chambers are a large danger to society. I don't like echo chambers, especially because a lot of people think that you can't have friends that have different opinions, so you literally like live your whole life with people that are just clones of your beliefs, and I think that's stupid. I don't know if it's like a danger to society. I think it's a danger for social growth, though, of the individuals. People treat like a differing opinion as like a crime that you can't just like be friends even though someone has a different belief. I think it's stupid. I think that's really dumb. Blowing it out of proportion in the opposite direction? Me? Or are you talking about the guy saying it's a danger to society? Like I said, I think when you just only surround yourself with people that echo everything you believe, I think you're doing yourself a disservice. I don't know why you just want to be surrounded by clones of yourself. Have you heard about the hallucinogenic spinach? Kind of Popeye shit is that? No, I haven't heard of the hallucinogenic spinach. Sounds hype though.